What I've done to set up for the next videos is set up a Drupal 7 site on the left-hand side and a Drupal 8 site on the right-hand side. Right now we're working with Drupal 7.4.1 and Drupal 8 Release Candidate 3. The specific versions of Drupal that you'll be using might be a little different, but the interface changes that we're about to review are nearly guaranteed to be identical. Once you have the Drupal codebase and a database ready to be populated through the installation process, you're presented with an installation screen, and here are the first changes between 7 and 8. You can see that the first step in Drupal 7 is to choose an installation profile, whereas the first step in Drupal 8 is to choose a language. This makes a lot of sense because if we don't speak English, then the words here aren't going to make a lot of sense. The other big difference here is that if we do choose a non-English language, then Drupal will download that translation and enable it for the next steps in the Drupal installation process. In Drupal 7, in order to install Drupal with another language, you would have to manually download that language. Notice that the look of the installation pages for Drupal 7 and Drupal 8 are a bit different. Drupal 7 uses the Drupalicon, that kind of weird droplet face, as a way to indicate the brand, whereas in Drupal 8, it just says Drupal, which is a little bit more clear to those who are new to Drupal and who aren't used to the weird face yet. The installation screens are a bit more compact as well. Instead of the white background across the entire screen, the white background is condensed around the options that we need to deal with in Drupal 8. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click Save and Continue in the Drupal 8 side. Here we're presented with the installation profile selection, and the options are the same, although there's a little bit more text around the minimal installation to make it clear that it's not a standard choice. I'm going to click Save and Continue on the Drupal 8 side and the Drupal 7 side. You can see here on Drupal 7 that we only have English enabled. Let's click Save and Continue. If we used Acquia Dev Desktop to set up our Drupal 7 site, then the Setting Up the Database section is skipped. Over here on the Drupal 8 side, we have the option to set up the database, and the options are pretty similar to Drupal 7. I'm going to click Save and Continue. The initial site configuration page here has been cleaned up a little bit. Instead of having the borders around each section, those have been removed. And the password checker is just a little bit more intuitive with the color scheme. I'm going to fill these out real quick. Notice here when I use admin for the password that we have a green bar, whereas if we do the same over here, let me work my way down the configuration to get to that point. It shows as red when the password strength is weak. In Drupal 8, it suggests that we make our password at least 12 characters, whereas it suggested 6 in Drupal 7. I'm going to scroll down here. I'm going to set the default country and the time zone. You can see that the select options are a little bit easier to read, and I'll click Save and Continue on both sides. Once Drupal is installed, notice that Drupal 8 heads right to the front page, whereas Drupal 7 has this transition page. Let's click Visit Your New Site here,